Today we're going to talk about how to groom your horse and the tools that we use to groom your horse. We groom to make sure that we get all the dirt and mud off our horses before they ride, and it helps to bring the oils from the skin up to the surface of the coat to make them shiny and keep their coats healthy. This also allows you to look over your horse and make sure they don't have any new cuts or scratches, and also helps you check for fungus. When we groom, we start with a brush called the curry comb. The curry comb is used to loosen all of the mud and dirt off of your horse's coats. We use this all over the horse's body, but not on their faces or their legs. After we've loosened the mud and dirt, we use the hard brush. The hard brush is used to brush all of the dirt that we just loosened off of the coat. We can use the hard brush all over the horse's body and down their legs. When you're doing their legs, you want to make sure that you squat on the ground and not put a knee or sit on the ground so that you can get up in case the horse were to move or spook. You also want to make sure that you scrub really well on the front of the cannon bone and down by the pastern and on the back of their fetlock, because this is where a lot of the mud usually gets when they're outside, and also where fungus typically develops. After we've done that, you use the soft brush. The soft brush is the last brush that we use, and it's a finishing brush to help get anything else off and make their coats shinier. We can use this all over the horse's body, down their legs, and on her face. When you're grooming the mane and tail, you can use a hard brush to brush out any of the sticks and dirt that might be on the surface of the mane and tail. This is a quick way to brush through it and make sure that it stays clean. But the best way to brush out your horse's mane and tail is to use a detangler and a mane or tail brush. So we'll spray the horse's mane with the detangler. And then you always want to start brushing at the bottom of the mane so that it prevents the hair from breaking and falling out. So we'll start at the bottom of the mane and work our way up to the top. And you can do this working all the way down.
When we move to groom the tail, we always want to make sure that we stand in a safe position. We don't want to stand directly behind the horse while we brush out her tail. So we'll stand to the side so that we can pull the tail towards us so that we're not in a place where we could get kicked right behind her. When we start, we're going to spray her tail with the detangler. And then we'll grab small sections of the tail and work from the bottom to the top of the tail to make sure that we don't rip out parts of the tail. We'll stand to the side, pull it towards us, and brush out small sections of the tail, working our way up until we get the whole tail brushed out.
When we go to pick out our horse's feet, we're going to stand next to their shoulder with our feet shoulders width apart, facing their tail. We are going to take our left hand and slide it down our horse's leg, and they should pick their foot up, but if they do not, we will squeeze the chestnut on the inside of their leg, which will get them to pick their feet up. We want to make sure that we keep our feet to the side of them, not underneath of them where they could step on our foot. When we take their foot and bend it up to their, towards their stomach, that also prevents them from being able to take it out of our hand as easily. Now we're going to take our pick with the pick portion facing away from us, and we will put it into the dirt on in the hoof and flick it out. When we pick out the feet, we want to make sure that we avoid the triangle section in the middle of their foot called the frog, because picking into this can hurt the horse. So we want to pick all around this portion, but not in the frog, and make sure we get all of the dirt out of the crevices and around their shoes. Next, we'll pick out the back feet. We'll stand next to their hip with our feet shoulders width apart, facing away from their head. We're going to take our left hand and slide it down the back of the horse's leg. When he picks it up, we're going to grab by their hoof, and then as the horse relaxes its leg, we'll pull it out back away from their body. We'll make sure that we keep our feet out from under them, and then pick out the foot, making sure that you avoid the frog. And then set it back down, making sure that your feet are still out of the way.